also would like to welcome and thank everyone for attending the White Coat Ceremony for the Alabama College of Osteopathic Medicine Class of 2021. We'd like to thank the Dothan Civic Center for allowing us to use this facility each year for this event. I also would like at this time to recognize members of our Houston County Healthcare Authority as well as our ACOM Board of Directors. Would you all please stand and let us acknowledge you. Our class of 2021 represents a diverse group of students from 24 states across the nation. This is ACOM's fifth class of students, and we are proud of the achievements that each of you have made to this date. It is exciting to see the vision of ACOM continue through the students. The White Coat Ceremony is a momentous occasion and a journey to becoming a physician, and we congratulate you on your successes that have brought you here today. At this time, I would like to introduce ACOM's founding dean, Dr. Craig Lentz.
This wonderful event. One of the things that I would like to do first is to remind all of you, and for some of you that may not know, some of the things that have gone on in the last academic year that we're so proud of. And that is that we celebrated our first campus expansion with Centers for Excellence in Team-Based Learning, Research, and Simulation Center, and now a Center for Excellence in Academic Support, for which we're very proud. We also had a team of second-year students that you may know about that went to the national competition for simulation, a simulation tournament, and we actually had our first and second-place competitors in that were both ACOM. groups of students, and we took first place, went to the internationals in France and won that as well, so that's quite a high. And in our graduating class, which we had our first graduation on May 13th, I'm proud to say that 100% of all those graduates that came across the stage were placed in residency. We have 69% of those being in what the classic description of primary care, but I'm even more proud that 25% of that 69% was in family practice. So that was a great achievement at graduation. And just prior to that, in April, on April 24th, after 7 long years of work from the time that we started this project, we were granted full accreditation for 7 years. And we're so proud of that as well. So that's what keeps us here. Now I think it's time to see if I can introduce our keynote speaker. I could take 10, 15 minutes reading through an extensive CV, and I really struggle with this, but I was introduced as the dean of the college, but Mr. Tom Gentile, just for all of you to get an understanding of what his biggest achievement is, as far as I'm concerned, is a dean of a medical school. A dean is to his students, years 1 through 4, as a DIO or DME, an institutional officer who has all of the residency programs and program directors reporting to him, is the equivalent on the residency side of a dean in a medical school. And Tom was DIO at the Providence Hospital in the Detroit area for 30 years. He was the chief academic officer and DIO for another 6 years at St. John Health in Detroit. Those two combined, and then he was senior vice president for academic affairs. So an incredible career of supervising and nurturing residents for a contribution that's really hard to measure. The combined system of St. John and Providence had 596 residents in 38 different programs that he was responsible for working with the program directors and supervising those programs. So I wanted to mention that. The other thing that I will tell you is that he was around long enough, going back 25 or 30 years, when there weren't DOs that were being taken into this program. Was virtually all MDs when it first started. And we have a great collegial relationship now that has been nurtured over the years, but he was one of the founders of that, nurturing that relationship when he started taking DOs into their fellowship programs at St. John and at the Providence. So the other thing I will tell you is that starting in 05, when I was in Tennessee working with the school there, we started on a journey of working together in starting new residency training programs, which are so badly needed in this country and in this region. So from then until 2010, and then in 2010, when I got here, I talked to Dr. Will Baker, our Dean for Clinical Resources, and I said one of the most important things that we can do, we have to search for third and fourth year experiences for all of you, but every time that you go to one of these locations, we should be trying to figure out who wants to start new residency training programs. Because we need them. We need them for all of you. And that started 7 years ago with the outreach after the Alabama Medical Education Consortium started with Dr. Will Baker and then joined ACOM. And the person that we used as a consultant that would come in and tell them how to start the programs and tell them how they would get the funding for it has been Mr. Tom Gentile. And if you look at this map, you will see Sheffield, Huntsville, Decatur, Gunnersville, Gadsden, Anniston, Birmingham, Centerville, Montgomery, Dothan, Southeast Alabama Medical Center, Foley, Fairhope, and Mobile, the infirmary system. He's been a consultant working with us for every one of those hospitals. And in coming in July of 2018, and this just happened this week, and it takes a long time to develop those. The first of those is at Southeast Alabama Medical Center, with 13 internal medicine residents being approved by ACGME and the Residency Review Committee for Internal Medicine, the first program of its kind for probably more than 30 years in Alabama, and we have more coming. We hope to have family practice in 18 in Foley, and that's thanks to Tom Gentile and Dr. Will Baker and the efforts of this college, this medical school, the only one of four campuses, medical campuses in the state of Alabama, pursuing this dream. So without further fanfare, and I just want to express my appreciation to Tom for everything he's done for the college and for all of you. Tom.